who am I talking to?
I'm Gratta from the People of Poet.
I'm Leon from the People of Poet.
Fantastic. And how long have you been musicians?
I've been singing and playing some stuff since maybe like 4 years. I joined the band about 3 years ago.
I've been in this band for about 6 or 7 years, and then I've been playing in bands since school, really. So.
Right. You made a lot of money?
No.
I mean, are you just about getting by with your gigs and that kind of thing? Is that how you make a living? Or
kind of juggle, real jobs, as right. you call them, yeah. back at home, and then play the shows, and it's like...
I guess
a holiday,
comes,
I suppose.
Yeah, it comes in waves, I guess, obviously, this because it's basically freelance playing music, so you'll get a really good month where you're really busy with some stuff, and then obviously PRS and stuff is kind of consistent money, so...
That's good. That's good. And, I mean, in the future, do you see yourself signing a record deal, or would you rather try and go, keep control of things yourself?
I think that depends on the artist. I think, personally, we would probably... we would benefit from having a label because the way that we want to go about things. But then you've got other people like Gratta, also sings backing vocals for an artist called Ola Gartland, and she does it all herself pretty much, and she does brilliant.
Right.
And she's probably going to take herself to a stage where labels are probably going to be, having to cough up the money that they used to. to be able to persuade it.
I think if you can manage on your own for as long as possible, and then maybe get a label on board, that would be kind of the idealistic way of doing it.
And what do you think about all the noise in the press and the media generally about artists complaining about their streaming royalties? Where do you think the fault lies there?
I'm not sure really. I guess Spotify is kind of the main talking point at the moment, the whole Taylor Swift thing, and it's just a really hard subject because, you want your music to be heard. Spotify is a really great way of doing that, especially for kind of wider audiences, in America, and especially if you live in Britain. So in a sense, it's really good because people will listen to your music, maybe buy gig tickets and come and see you, or maybe buy the EP or album that you have up. But also, people will obviously listen a lot to your music and not pay anything for it, so it's very kind of a confusing situation.
Yeah. But do you think that streaming is the future, and that the artists will eventually start to make some decent money from streaming?
I think it's there already. I mean, this is what people do now. No one buys anything anymore, I don't feel. It's very rare when people do. But hopefully something will happen where, each play an artist gets maybe like...
The final releases seem to be going up again. So that's only a good thing, really.
Absolutely.
I think it's kind of just giving artists more of a reason to think outside of the box and try and think of ways, not just producing a CD which they'll just go chuck in the pile and burn it and put it on their laptop kind of thing. It's more, giving something that they'll, want to cherish kind of thing. Like, we released a book, and you got a lot of artists releasing a book, but we did an entire album based on our fans' life stories. We got like the lyrics on the one side of the page, and then you've got the life stories which inspired the lyrics on the other page. And our main reason behind that was not only to be unique and to stand out, but to make fans want to buy music, like, physical music.
That's a really good idea. It's a really good idea. Thank you ever so much for your help.
Thank you.
And good luck with your careers.
Thank you.
Cheers. Bye-bye.